I'd like to see 10,000 people give $10,000.
Write your biggest check and send it in.
We got people on welfare that's got enough faith to make $1,000 now and paying it.
I want to be in the green lawn.
What I'm about to say is revelation. I got it on DVD, and I have it on DVD, and you need to get this. Hallelujah.
Get your face on the street.
Hallelujah.
Gotta kick back, step back. Oh, you got to ski.
Reverend, what did I call you?
No, just call me Doctor.
Doctor?
Yeah.
All right, Doc. First of all, I have to tell you, when I heard that you were in Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, I was like, that's my man. And it's funny because that lyric can be interpreted religiously, if you don't know me by now.
Right?
Right? I mean, you must have thought of that.
The song did go platinum. Teddy Pendergrass, who led the song, he was ordained a minister when he was 10 years old.
What do you think it says about religion and how serious it is if you can be a minister when you're 10? But there is a comparison to be made between musical stars, rock stars, and religious figures. They very often both dress in elaborate costumes that get people's attention.
737 coming, water to sky. Well, won't you take me down to Memphis on a midnight ride? I won't move. Hey, you need a traveling pain. Yeah. Well, I'm trying to get
people in a congregation must know that the outfit was financed by their donations, that it doesn't seem to bother them.
I always dress well.
I see.
So it's not
those
that
gators?
I'm... Those
gators?
Those are lizards.
Lizards?
Mm. Yes.
Where do they run?
They don't run, they crawl.
And I see you got a lot of bling.
I like gold. The people want you to look well.
That's what pimps say about their women.
I was told by one of the greatest pimps that ever lived. His name is called God. That if you know what you got, then you ain't got much.
Jesus dressed very well.
Come on. Where is the biblical evidence?
When he was born, they brought him gold. They brought him gold. He was not poor.
So my image of Jesus as a man who championed the poor and walked around in simple garb, that's wrong?
It was linen. It was fine linen.
Really?
Yeah.
But Jesus constantly preaches against rich people.
The Bible does not speak against being rich.
Jesus does.
No.
Very plainly.
No.
Jesus was very, very against the rich.
He never preached against being poor. Blessed are the poor in spirit.
He preached against being rich.
No. It said that it's better for a rich man
It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom.
Okay, but now things like houses and cars and clothes and money, they come as a result of my seeking God first.
I don't remember that in the New Testament specifically,
but it's there.
That passage about
I remember it.
The houses and the cars and the clothes, they'll come.
Yeah. Money comes. Money happens, you know.
Well, money happens for you because they're giving it up to you. You're not giving it up to them.
As a matter of fact, let me set the record straight. I do not receive a salary from the church. I do not take a salary from the church.
You take it right out of the pot.
No.
It's such a powerful position. I mean, you hold people's greatest hopes and dreams in the palm of your hand, really. Certainly some of the young women must get a crush on you.
Probably. I would, too, if I was out there. If I was a woman, I'd probably have a crush on me, too, you know?
That's keeping it real.
You know? Now I can advise other young men about women, because I've been there. I had a young man who was about to go crazy over a woman. He was about to kill himself, you know? I said, that kind of passion you should have for God. Mm. I said, turn that to God and see what happened.
St. Paul, for example, who I know you compare yourself to.
People do. Yes.
Okay. But he famously only wore on his back the clothes that he owned.
Mm-hmm.
Should I assume that this is
on a run?
This is your only $2,000 suit?
The gentleman who made this suit for me owns a clothing store.
Okay, Mr. K, you're in the house.
The prices that I get my clothes for, You know, yeah. I'm blessed in that area.
Yes,
you know?
You are.
I'm more blessed than I've ever been all the days of my life.
And the owner is a Muslim, which I came out of Islam.
I know, and I think it's very interesting that you're a Christian now, mm-hmm. you were a Muslim, and when you get your clothes, you buy them like a Jew.